It's got honey in it.
Ooh.
Yeah. Stout with honey.
I think they all have.
All right.
It's
okay.
Just to beef up the egg here, yeah, but.
Hello.
Hello.
50-50. Done by Opzine and Adam from Adam's Craft Beers. Last time we had 50-50, it was really good.
Yeah.
Rob, on a recent trip to Copenhagen, picked this up from a bottle shop. It says it was a really good bottle shop.
It was.
This is the Green Top 2014 Eclipse Barrel-Aged. Let's cook it up.
Yeah. Rittenhouse Rye Whiskey Barrels this
week. Yeah.
Talk amongst yourselves while I try and get the lid off, but I'm doing quite
well. Wow, doing a pretty good job there. I mean, Rob's strength.
Professional. Well, Adam, if it came down to strength, it'd have been you. I would have obviously passed.
I'm the weakest one of these three. See, I can't count either.
Here, your glass.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I do apologize.
Too busy taking photos.
Yeah. Looks beautiful. I can smell that from here. That's. So,
beautiful cutting on the edge.
It really is, and it's fairly carbonated as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Lovely kind of mocha top on that one. It's fairly thin, it's disappeared. But I'm surprised how carbonated that is, but lacing a beauty. Look at that lacing on the glass. Yeah. It's just alcohol legs for days.
Black as night, I mean. Yeah. It looks like Imperial Stout.
Really does.
So check out the aroma.
Check it out.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's really actually a lot sweeter than I expected it to be.
It's so contained. It's really.
Do you know what? It's such a mellow aroma for 11.9, though, isn't it?
Yeah. It is quite spirit led, though. I mean, I think definitely the barrels are the prominent aroma on it.
Well,
it is. For me, it does have kind of like a spirit, kind of like turps, a bit. Literally alcohol.
Yeah.
But not burning your nostrils off.
No. Yeah, I can see that. It's quite fruity, I'm going to say. It's quite more, so it's like, you know, stone dark fruits. But it's definitely whiskey forward, but you do get a little bit of oak.
Fruit. Definitely lots of oak.
Yeah.
It's not the sweeter coffee and chocolate. Caramel,
I mean, that's the last thing that I would have actually expected from this beer, and the aroma kind of indicates that. So, let's check it out.
Cheers. That's good.
Yeah, I guess that's one thing that we didn't point out. It says Brewed with honey.
Yeah.
And I thought that might have been just a way of bumping up the ABV, but I think you do get it.
No, you really do.
I'll try to pick up on the aroma. It's really simple. The aroma.
Now a couple of seconds, after that's gone down, you get a real sort of almost juicy. It's like, you know when you've like actually squeezed honey into your mouth.
If you've done that.
I actually have done that. But you get like a real kind of like
body
warmth of honey. Yeah, that's what we do apparently.
That's how they get the tan.
But
it's honey.
You get a lot of that honey on the back end. I'm really surprised about that because it kind of overpowers the whiskey almost.
It's quite a waxy, earthy honey.
The texture and quality and
body on that is fantastic, isn't it?
That
top end of medium, bottom end of full.
It just
improves the kind of drinking experience, I'd say.
I think you get the rye whiskey quality in the middle of the palate. It kind of almost kind of spikes with a tiny little bit of what could be confused with bitterness, but I think it's just dryness.
Yeah.
Dry kind of spiciness almost from the whiskey.
Currants and black pepper.
Definitely.
Well, again, and the
rice coming out. That's the spiciness, isn't it? Yeah. I guess. Yeah. That honey is just taking me by surprise in the back end.
Yeah, it's nice.
Wow.
Yeah, I think it's lovely. I mean, I really like this range of beers. I mean, they are very expensive, but sometimes
you can taste the price in that.
Oh that's
the quality is really good. You mean they're expensive beers in America, so when you see them in Europe, you're obviously going to expect them to be expensive still. But
and it's travelled and aged as well, so that's another market.
It's a world traveller. It's gone from California to Denmark, and then from Denmark to England. And
Yorkshire.
If you've got a bottle of this at the moment, I think now's the perfect time to drink it. I could not imagine that being any better now. I mean, if it's aged anymore, I don't really know what would happen.
It would fall out and it would be just...
But I think that's spot on right now. I really do. Yeah, definitely.
Lovely stuff. Mm. So that is 2014 bottle of 50-50 Eclipse. This is the green, dark green wax Rittenhouse Rye Whiskey Barrels, 11.9% ABV.
See it, buy it. definitely.
Lovely.
See you next time.
Cheers.
Bye.